The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 8th Chapter, Text Number 23, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 15th, 1973, in Los Angeles.
Translation: O Hrishikesha, Master of the Senses and Lord of Lords, you have released your mother Devaki, who was long imprisoned and distressed by the envious King Kamsa, and myself and my children from a series of constant dangers.
This is the position of devotees, that Devaki, who happens to be the mother of Krishna, she is not ordinary woman. Who can become the mother of the Supreme Personality of Godhead? The most advanced devotee. So that Krishna has agreed to become her son. In his previous life, the husband and wife, they underwent severe austerities, and when Krishna appeared before them and wanted to give them benediction, they wanted a son like God. So, where can be another person who is equal to God? That is not possible. God means there is no equal, there is no greater. Asama urdhva. There is God. God, there cannot be any competition that you are God, I am God, he is God, he is God. No. These are dogs. They are not God. God means without competition. One. God is one. Nobody is greater, asama urdhva. Nobody is greater than him. Nobody is equal to him. Everyone is lower. Ekala, Ishan, Krishna, Arsabhritta. Only master is Krishna, God, and everyone's servant. Never mind, even if he is Brahma, Vishnu, or Shiva, big demigods, and what to speak of others. Shiva Vinanchi Nutam. In the Shastra it is said that he is offered respect by Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma. They are the topmost demigods. There are demigods. Above the human being, there are demigods. As we are human beings, above the lower creatures, lower animals. Similarly, above us, there are demigods. And the most important demigod is Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva. Lord Brahma is the creator of this universe. And Lord Shiva is the destroyer of this universe. And Lord Vishnu is the maintainer. Lord Vishnu is Krishna himself. So, for the maintenance of this material world, there are three gunas. Satagun, Rajagun, Tamagun. So, each one of them has taken charge of one department. So, Lord Vishnu has taken the department of Satogun, and Lord Brahma has taken the department of Rajogun, and Lord Shiva has taken the department of Tamagun. They are not under the influence of these gunas. Just like as the superintendent of jail, he is not a prisoner. He is controlling officer. Similarly, Lord Shiva, Lord Vishnu, Lord Brahma, although they are controlling each department, they are not under the controlling department. We may not commit mistake. So, Rishikesha, Krishna is the supreme controller. Rishik means senses. So we are enjoying our senses, but ultimately the controller is Krishna. Suppose this is my hand, I am claiming it is my hand, I shall give you a good feast on you. I am very much proud, but I am not controller. The controller is Krishna. If he withdraws the power of the activity of your arm, you become paralyzed. Although you are claiming, it is my hand, I shall use it. But when it is paralyzed, you cannot do anything. Therefore, I may have possessed this hand by the grace of Krishna, but I am not the controller. That is Krishna consciousness. Therefore, a sane man will think that ultimately if this hand is to be controlled by Krishna, then it is meant for Krishna. This is the common sense, understand? I am claiming that this is my hand, this is my leg, this is my ear. Even children says, ask the children, what is this? It is my hand. But we may claim, but actually it is not our hand. It is given. Because I wanted to use my hands in so many ways, Krishna has given all lives. You take this hand, use it. It is gift of Krishna. Therefore, a sane man is always conscious that whatever I have got in my position, first of all this body and senses, they are actually not mine. I have given all these possessions for utility. So if ultimately everything belongs to Krishna, why it is not utilized for Krishna? That is Krishna consciousness. That is Krishna consciousness. That is intelligence. If I am given all these things for my use, for my sense gratification, but ultimately it belongs to Krishna, everyone is part and parcel of Krishna. Everyone's senses are also Krishna's. So when the senses are utilized for Krishna's service, that is perfect. But so long it is utilized for my sense gratification, it is Maya. Therefore, bhakti means Rishikena Rishikesa Sevanang Bhakti Ruchat. Rishikena, by the senses, this is Rishikesha, Sevanam. When you serve Rishikesha, really master of the senses, that is called bhakti. Very simple description, definition of bhakti. Rishikena Rishikesha Sevanam. Rishikesha Sevanam. Not Rishik Sevanam. Rishik means senses. So, when senses are used for sense gratification, that is Maya. And when senses are used for the gratification of the master of the senses, that is called bhakti. Very simple definition. Anyone can understand. So, generally, in this material world, everyone is using the senses for sense gratification. That's all. That is their bondage. That is Maya, illusion. And when he comes to Krishna consciousness, purified, when he understands that actually these senses are meant for satisfying Krishna, then he is liberated person. Mukta, Mukta Purus, liberated person. Iha jasya harir dasye, karmana manasa bhasa. When one comes to this position, that my senses are meant for serving the master of the senses, Rishikesha. The master of the senses is sitting within your heart. In the Bhagavad Gita it is said, sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishtam. I am seated in everyone's heart. Matta smriti jnanam apuhanam. From me, remembrance, knowledge, and forgetfulness is coming. So, why that? Because Krishna is so merciful. If I want to use my senses in a certain way, not my senses, it is Krishna's given. So Krishna gives the chance, all right, utilize it. Suppose I've got tongue. If I want, Krishna, I want to eat stool. I want to taste stool. Yes, Krishna will say, yes, you can take this body of hog and eat stool. The master is there, Krishna. Therefore Krishna says, matta smriti jnanam apaharaj. He gives you the body, reminds you, my dear living entity, you wanted to eat stool, now you have got a proper body. Now it lies, here is stool also. Similarly, if you want to become demigod, that also Krishna gives you chance. Anything. There are 8,400,000 forms of life. If you want to engage your senses in any type of body, Krishna is giving you, come on, here is the body you take. But we become exasperated by using our senses. Ultimately we become senseless. Therefore Krishna says, sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekaṁ śaraṇam. Don't do like this. Your senses are meant for serving me. So you are misusing it. By misusing, you are being entrapped in different types of body. Therefore, to get relief from this tedious business of accepting one body and giving it up, again another body, anything like that, to continue this material existence, if you give up this process of sense gratification and surrender unto me, then you are saved. This is Krishna consciousness. So, at the present moment, our senses are contaminated. I am thinking I am American. So, my senses should be utilized for the service of my country, my society, my nation, big, big leaders, big, big, so many things. So the real concept is that I am American. So, my senses are American senses. So it must be utilized for American. Similarly, Indians are thinking, others are thinking, but none of them do know it, that senses belong to Krishna. This is ignorance. No intelligence. They are thinking for the time being, that these senses, upadhi, designate, American senses, Indian senses, African senses. No, this is called Maya. It is cover. Therefore, bhakti means sarvapadhi vinirmuktam. When your senses will be uncontaminated with all these diseases, that is the beginning of bhakti. If I think I am American, why shall I take Krishna consciousness? It is Hindu God. Well, that is foolishness. If I think I am Mohammedan, I am Christian, then you are gone. But if we purify the senses, that I am spirit soul, the supreme spirit soul is Krishna, I am part and parcel of Krishna, therefore it is my duty to serve Krishna, then you become free immediately. You are no more American, Indian, or African, or this or that. You are Krishna, Krishna consciousness. That is what. Therefore, Kunti Devi says, Rishikesha, my dear Krishna, You are the master of the senses. And for the sense gratification, we are fallen in this material condition of life, different varieties of life. So, we are suffering. In the suffering to the extent, even one becomes Krishna's mother, because this is material birth, she is also put into suffering. But speak of others. Devaki is so advanced that she has become the mother of Krishna. But still, he is put into difficulties. Difficulties by whom? By his brother, Kamsa. So this world is like that. Try to understand. Even you become Krishna's mother, and even your brother, who is very nearest relative, the world is such, jealous, that if one's personal interest is hampered, everyone will be ready to give you trouble. This is the world. Everyone, even if his brother, even his father, what to speak of others? Khalena. Khala means jealous. This material world is jealous, envious. I am envious of you, you are envious of me. This is our business. This is our business. Therefore, this Krishna consciousness movement is for such person who is no more jealous, who is no more envious. Perfect person. Dharma projita koita vayatra parama nirma saranam satang vastava vastu vidnama. Those who are jealous and envious, they are within this material world. And those who are not jealous, they are in the spiritual world. Just a simple thing. You test yourself. Whether I am jealous, envious of my other associates, friends, everything, then I am in the material world. And if I am not jealous, then I am the spiritual one. Anyone can test. There is no question of whether I am spiritually advanced or not. You can test yourself. Bhakti parishanu bhava virakti annatrasyat. Just like if you are eating, you will understand whether you are satisfied, whether your hunger is satisfied. You haven't got to take certificate from others. Similarly, if you test yourself, whether you are jealous, whether you are envious, then you are in the material world. And if you are not jealous, if you are not envious, then in the spiritual world. Then you can serve Krishna very nice. If you are not jealous, because power, jealous, envious has began from Krishna, just like the Mahabharata. Why Krishna shall be God? I am also God. So this is the beginning of material life, to become envious of Krishna. Why Krishna shall be enjoyed? I shall be enjoyed. Why Krishna shall enjoy the gopis? I shall become Krishna and enjoy, make a society of gopis and enjoy. This is Maya. Nobody can be enjoyer. Krishna therefore says, Bhoktanam Jagrasi. Krishna is the only enjoyer. And if we supply ingredients for his enjoyment, that is our perfection of life. And if we want to imitate Krishna, that I shall become a god, I shall become an imitator, enjoyer, then you are in the mind. Simply, our business is just like the gopi's life. Krishna is enjoying, and they are supplying the ingredients of enjoyment. Yes. This is bhakti. We are meant for, Krishna is supplying the servant and master. The servant is being supplied all the necessities by the master. But the servant's duty is to serve the master. That's all. Ego bahunangju vidadhati kaman nitya nityanam chetana chetana. These are the basic impulses. Krishna is supplying you immense. All the necessities of life. There is no scarcity. There is no economic problem. You simply try to serve Krishna, then everything is complete. Because he is Rishikesha. Where so much Krishna desires, there may be ample supplies. Just like in your country, there is ample supplies. In other country, I went to Switzerland, everything is imported, no supply. The supply is only snow. Take as much snow as you like. You see? Similarly, everything is under the control of Krishna. If you become devotee, then there is no snow supply, simply food supply. And if you don't become devotee, be covered with snow, that's all. Covered with cloud. Everything is under Krishna's control. So actually there is no scarcity. The scarcity is Krishna consciousness. So if you become Krishna conscious, then everything is ample. There is no scarcity. This is the path. Tayarishikesha. And yet we say, Tayarish, Jatharishikesha Khalina Diva. The world is full of dangers. But Devaki, Kunti Devi says, but because Devaki is your devotee, you saved her from the distresses offered by her envious brother. As soon as the brother heard that my sister's son, eighth son of my sister, will kill me, he was ready immediately to kill Devaki. So he was pacified by Devaki's husband. It is the duty of the husband to give protection. Yeah, my dear brother-in-law, why you are envious to your sister? After all, your sister will not kill you. Her son will kill you. That is the problem. So I shall deliver all the sons to you. Then you can do whatever you like. Why you are killing this innocent girl? Newly married, she is your younger sister, just like your daughter, you should give her protection. What you are doing? So Kansa became pacified. He believed in the words of Vasudeva that he will deliver all the sons, and if you like, can kill. He thought, let me save the present situation. After all, later on, when Kansa gets a nephew, he may forget this enviousness, but he is never to forget. He killed all the sons and kept them in prison. Sucharpita, vadhya, atichiram. Atichiram meant for a long time. So, you are saved. Devaki, you are saved after all. Similarly, if you take the position of Devaki and Kunti. Kunti, just like with her sons, Pancha Pandav, five Pandav. After she became widow, the whole plan was, Dhritarashtra's, how to kill these children of my younger brother. Because by chance I was blind, so I could not get the throne of the kingdom. My younger brother got it. Now he is dead. That at least my sons, they should get the throne. That was his policy, Dhritarashtra's policy. I could not get. This is material propensity. I shall be happy, my sons shall be happy, my community shall be happy, my nation shall be happy. These are extended selfishness. Nobody is thinking Krishna, how Krishna will be happy. Everyone is thinking in his own terms. How I shall be happy, how my children shall be happy, my community shall be happy, my society shall be happy, my nation. This is the struggle for existence. Everybody will find. This is material existence. Nobody is thinking how Krishna will be happy. Therefore, this Krishna consciousness is very sublime. Try to understand from Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita. And Rishikena Rishikesha Sevanam. And try to engage your senses for the service of the master of the senses. Then you'll be happy. Thank you very much.